Thank you. Alright, so this is where the incident took place. Now, the police station is literally right around the corner. It's like less than 5 minutes, especially if they're speeding. It could have came two different routes. This route might have been the fastest one. Or, oh, also too, the fire station is right there. Fire department. And then they could have took this route right here. Not to mention all the houses in the area, nobody called 911 after this dude just aired out the block. That's kind of funny. And it took them an hour to respond. This area, there's no crime like that, especially not no whole lot of just craziness. So this town got a lot of secrets and a lot of stuff going on that's been kept under wraps. In small town America, places like this right here, they get away with all type of stuff because nobody really digs and looks into it. And it's so much corruption, people, everybody's tied in with it. Somebody has an interest or money is involved. So that first clip that you seen, that was going to be used as a foundation or comparison to this next clip. Now, it took them almost an hour to respond, right? Nobody called 911. Right, or if somebody did, they obviously didn't, because it came right away. Okay, so there was kind of something fishy about that. Now, in this town, there was an incident that happened, and coincidentally, it happened on the same day that this is a stage car accident. I'm telling you, this is a stage car accident, and it's only done for one reason.
If 2 + 2 = 4,
right?
And 5 + 5 = 10.
Okay.
What the fuck is this?
Things are just not gonna add up, and you're gonna see like, wow, they responded entirely too fast. Like they were right there. How come they didn't respond like that on the first call? And then a real crime, a quadruple murder, was happening on that same day, around that same particular time. Right? So let's go ahead and roll it.
As a victim at this time, to ensure that the family has time to be notified and for them to grieve in private before it becomes public.
The Henry County Sheriff's Office is now in possession of 4 murder warrants for Mr. Andrew Longmore. Date of birth, 11/3/1982. We're working in conjunction with the GBI, Henry County Police, U.S. Marshal, Henry County Fire, EMA, and every Metro Atlanta Police Public Safety Agency. This is an all-hands-on-deck movement to make sure that we place Mr. Andrew Longmore in custody. The Henry County Sheriff's Office is also offering a $10,000 reward for any information leading to the arrest and apprehension and prosecution of Mr. Longmore. If you see Mr. Longmore, please call 911. Do not approach him because he is known to be armed and dangerous.
Today is a sad and somber occasion that we've gathered here today. The city of Hampton has had a tragedy, but we are sworn to and convinced that we will make sure that each and every person that is that's responsible for this tragedy here in our community will be brought to justice. We ask that you lift up the families and the victims in your prayers, your thoughts, and that you give them the privacy that they may need to overcome this horrific tragedy. We have full confidence in our law enforcement agency that they will perform their duties and bring this suspect to justice. We're going to have prayer for our entire community, and we're asking that the community would come together in their search for this suspect.
Now, pay attention to the date and the time. Okay, pay close attention to that. You're gonna have to forgive me because the camera was just shaking like crazy. Whatever the case may be, I'm sorry about that. But you're gonna see this is a controlled, boom, one mailbox, boom, two mailbox. I said it was a medical emergency. Now, if she just slammed on the gas, she wouldn't turn the wheel. She would go straight and plot into that house, into that backyard. But instead, it was a controlled crash. Right? Now watch the time. 10:44. The quadruple murder started at 10:45. Now let's see how long it takes for the police to respond to this. It's a car accident now. Not a shooting. A car accident. Now there was a neighbor on the porch right over there. They sat there and watched it. That's actually at one of the officials, one of the major officials' houses. He comes over all nonchalant. When I went back and reviewed it, I was like, he's walking over there. This person just took out two mailboxes and crashed. You're walking. Passenger gets out. This is all staged. For somebody who's so concerned, he's literally standing there with his hands on his hips. He's not calling 911. Maybe she is, or she's over there checking on him. How come he hasn't called anybody yet? Somebody else has. Somebody just drives on by. They don't stop. And watch the time. 10:46. And speed it up. Now 10:44 is when it started. Now see one, two, there's two squad cars pulled up. Response time. The police station is literally 2-3 minutes around the corner. And then a quadruple homicide happened 3 minutes down the road. Now pay attention to this white car right here, because the driver of the car gets out and walks straight across. Now a third squad car pulls up. So you got two SUVs and a pickup truck. All within like less than 5 minutes in response time. And here comes this guy. He makes it his business to walk straight right up here, up the walkway. There's definitely a sidewalk on that street. But he cuts all the way across the grass. And then goes over there. Doesn't go up to the car where they're at. He goes over to one of the neighbors. Just to be in the mix. I mean, some people are nosy, but obviously he's not that concerned. What can you do in this situation? Can't do anything. The law enforcement's already there. Ambulance should be pulling up any second. Doesn't seem right. Now look at how many people gathered up around here. Conversated about this accident, whatever the case may be. Ain't nobody come outside when them shots rang out. Everybody is all of a sudden in concern. Cops pull up real quick. Ambulance should be pulling up any minute now. Help, no, fire department. So we got three vehicles, three cops out there, fire department, and EMS, all in less than 10 minutes response time. That's how they should have responded to the first incident. Nobody game. That doesn't seem right at all. That was all staged just to knock out those mailboxes. It was all staged.
Metro Atlanta area, the entire state of Georgia can breathe a little easy. Tonight, the monster's dead.
Yeah, this is where it all went down, at a home right down the street behind me. We talked with neighbors and people who were at that house when the shootout ended. In a Clayton County neighborhood, two friends planned to start their Sunday with a backyard barbecue.
We opened up the backyard, the door to put the coal into the grill and stuff. A naked guy with a gun came jumping off the cliff. Sam let us in the house, let me in the house and stuff.
Corey Cloud was staying at his friend Justin's place off Wagon Wheel Court.
He was just like, I'm a good person. Can you please let me in?
Corey says he immediately shut the door while Justin went to find police to tell them there was a man with a gun crouched down by their back door.
The police charged in there and we hear all these gunshots.
Justin says he heard the shots from outside his home. Jimmy Jones says he heard them from his house one street over.
I heard at least a good 9 shots go off.
Corey says he heard the shots too.
All you hear is his bullets.
Because he says he was inside the house when it happened.
Right in front of me. I was trying to squeeze behind the sofa.
Corey and Justin say they had no idea who the man was when they got police. After, they learned that man was Andre Longmore, the suspect in Saturday's shooting that left 4 people dead in Hampton.
Some people might say that I'm just paranoid, but look at the response time. That's why I had to use something as comparison, because it took a whole hour, and somebody just emptied out a whole, just like aired out the whole block. That's loud. That's not something that's just, and now this, all of a sudden everybody's out there all concerned. They're grouping up. This dude cuts across the lawn, whatever the case may be. Then they're all grouped up. I don't want to talk to none of you. I don't trust none of y'all. First thing, officer, is this your mailbox? Why? It doesn't even matter. All right? You ain't going to pay for it. They knocked it over. All right? And then look, had 3 squad cars out there, the EMS, and the fire department. And like I said, the fire department was right down the street. All right? Now, this is just one, so we're gonna solidify this. There was another thing that was staged, a whole lot of police chase. They were chasing somebody with a stolen vehicle, right? Cuts through, you almost hits me. Yeah. And then the thing is, they cut back through the yard like twice, and it didn't make sense. If you're trying to get away from them, you'd be looking for a straightaway or the highway or something like that. And you're not going to drive around the same block and within the same neighborhood, just looping around. It was just crazy. You're going to see. So check this out. So again, sorry for the poor video quality. This is before I was able to do some other things. But I was getting myself ready. I was sitting up there working. I was changing. I believe I was about to crawl up underneath the house or something like that, do some repairs and check some stuff. So here goes this supposed stolen vehicle that's in a police chase right now. And then right here, this is where I'm about to almost get hit and I ran out the way. And that yard is big, so he had plenty of room to go anywhere. And then he like, you had to have been there. Like he was looking me in my face like, shit, I missed. And then later on, one of the officials calls City Hampton Police Department over there. Then they said they want to come take pictures of the grass or whatever the case may be, wherever the car drove through, and any other SUV, the other units rode through the lawn. I was like, all right, God, do what you gotta do. Send third. I guess they expected me to hold a whole conversation with him. I just pointed, hey, it's over there, and it's right there in the lawn right there. He had never even walked back there really to go take no pictures of it at all. And then they left. But the whole time it was sketched. It was just like, he was trying to get me to talk to him and extra stuff. And I'm just like, bro, it wasn't me? The fuck? When I tell you this town is so corrupt. This is the thing, right? It's all about property and money. And my family's in on it and everything. I just wanted to show y'all this to kind of lay down the foundation of how crazy this has just been insane. And you need to go down to that description box below and check out some of the other videos that's down there. Because, like I said, I got some lawsuits I'm working on. But all my lines of communication are compromised. My phone, internet, I'm going to get to all that, you know. But I had got you guys' attention prior, so I'm going to try to hold on to it while I still can. Like I said, man, I'm not exaggerating at all. I might not be around. I'm praying that I still am. But this situation is serious. So with this guy, Mr. Longmore, whatever it may be, and what he did, like, it just didn't add up. He was he served in Iraq and in Afghanistan. And then he just spazzes out all of a sudden, and then just, what was the reason? What was the cause? You know, I know what they're doing to me, and they've been trying to push me to the edge and stuff like that. But this man was military trained. He wasn't, I don't know. I don't know, and I want to, you know, put nothing out there like that. But it just doesn't add up. And then it was like, hush, hush. What would make that man just spazz out all of a sudden? The only other people that have PTSD or that served in the armed forces, most of the time they hurt themselves before they go hurt anybody else. I mean, because they took off to sworn to protect and, you know, us and stuff like that. So what really went down in that neighborhood? What made him do what he did? Over the kids be, and then even the witness that the last person he seen before, spoke to before he died, before the cops shot him, he told him that he was a good person after he just killed four people. But you know, but like, let's get back to the topic at hand. Like, all that stuff was staged, man. All those officials down there are dirty, bro. It's a bunch of shit going on. They've been legit trying to just set me up, trying to get me killed. Like, and like, even with this car chase, that shit was, it was all staged. The whole car, it's a lot of stuff that's been going on, man. And like, I can't really just talk about it openly on, you know, because it's a lot to encapsulate. I'm talking about like multiple attempted murders, just trying to set me up in all kind of ways, and just people, it's too many people involved. So look, like I said, man, just rock with me on this journey, or whatever the case may be. I gotta stop saying what that, what I keep saying. I get in a bad habit of saying that. And I'll try to explain and lay this out the best way I can. But go down to those videos or whatever. Go down and watch those other videos and stuff like that. And I know it's gonna seem crazy, whatever case. I keep wanting to say that. It's gonna seem crazy or whatever, but I had to do it for a reason. But I need you guys' help. The only way that I'm gonna get justice is if it's mainstream media. Even if I get attorneys, so all these attorneys I spoke to are dirty. They are dirty. They didn't try to set me up on the phone.
Hey, is there any attorneys available to do a consultation?
Okay, is it for a criminal case?
It's actually pretty complicated. I mean, really civil and criminal. Okay. In a sense, but we've just got a couple questions.
Okay, we don't do civil, we only do criminal defense. So if it's a criminal charge that you're looking for representation on, I can get you in touch with an attorney, yes. If it's civil, then you would need to contact a civil attorney.
Okay.
So we don't do both. We're not a law. We only do criminal defense, nothing else. We do no other type of law. So if you're looking for someone to be able to do both, civil and criminal, we wouldn't be able to help you. Now, we specialize in criminal, so if you need somebody that's a criminal attorney, I'd recommend talking to one of the attorneys.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay, and what county is it in? Because depending upon the county that it would be in, would be who I need to put you in touch with.
Well, actually, it's to the point where I can't even give that information. I just got a couple of questions to see if you guys would be able to help me at all.
Okay. Do you want to ask?
I would like to speak to somebody. Doesn't matter. I'm going to take a couple minutes.
Okay. All right, hold on.
Okay.
Hi, this is Nick. I'm one of the attorneys here.
Hey, Nick. Just got a quick question. I've been having a really hard time finding an attorney concerning this matter. So, let me ask you this. What would you do in a criminal case when the police department tampered with evidence? How would you proceed in that, or what's the route that you can take, or would take?
Yeah, it's far, far too vague of a question for me to answer.
Too vague of a question? It's kind of direct.
You think it's direct, but I think it's vague. Can you describe? There's all kinds of different ways police can tamper with evidence. They can throw it out the window. They can burn it. Depends on what evidence you're talking about. Was it a video that they destroyed? Was it actual physical evidence? Was it fingerprints? They create something out of nowhere. Like, you're just saying they tampered with evidence, and I have no idea what you're talking about. So why don't you be more specific, and I'll see if I can answer your question.
Okay, let's say,
Why are you dealing in hypotheticals anyway? Why don't you just tell me what's going on with you? This is a confidential conversation, and I can tell you how we can help.
Well, actually, because all my lines of communication are compromised, so that's another reason why I'm like, I can't, it's been hard enough for me to find an attorney. But I feel like, regardless of what, okay, let's say it's fingerprints. Let's say that. Let's say, you know, there was some falsification of a fingerprint in a criminal investigation. You know, what could be done with that? Even if you went to attorney.
How were they falsified?
There was no prints. The prints weren't. Just fake. It's bogus.
All right. Have a good day, man.
See there? That's what I get. That's what I fucking get. That's what I'm saying. See, motherfucker. let me go ahead and turn this bitch off. Oh man. See? This shit. Let me just plug this bitch all the way out. Plug out my Wi-Fi, cause all that shit's hacked and tampered and shit. Like, it's like, oh, this is a confidential conversation. No, the fuck is not. Ain't none of my conversations. This is confidential. There's nothing that I fucking do that's confidential. And that's the shit they run with you. Oh, this is a confidential conversation, blah, 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 blah. Or whatever the case may be. To get you to talk about some shit. Now remember, see the first thing he said. The first thing he fucking said was video distant 30. Went straight to it. That's using the Socratic method or Socrates method in order to use a line of questioning to get a specific answer out of you. If I just said the police department tampered with evidence, that's fucking direct. It doesn't matter what the fuck it is. You can't do that. Or this, from on my part or on their part, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was just and you know what I'm saying? And the thing is, lawyers are real skilled at wordplay. You see what I'm saying? And as soon as I said, he's like, why do you gotta be vague? Let's talk about what's going on with you directly. I said, hell nah, nigga, I ain't fuck no. I'm not, no. And this is what it comes down to. And I got a whole bunch of phone calls just like that. I can tell them, I'm like, no, I'm not fucking telling you shit, bitch. Until we sign paperwork and get under contract and shit like that, I am not, no. Negatory. Not doing it. Because even like this, boom, perfect example. When you are contacting a law firm, right? And even in the email, when you're corresponding with them and stuff like that. And you have to be careful when you're fucking corresponding with these people. Because a lot of times, I'm sorry. You tell them everything about your fucking case, right? And they say, sorry, we can't take your case. But you just gave this motherfucker everything. And if your phone call is recorded, or if the email that you sent, or whatever, is, compromise and shit like that. You just gave him everything. You know what I'm saying? And at the bottom of each correspondence with any law firms, I had to think about where I was going with this. At the bottom of the email, it'll say, "This is not established client attorney privilege," or whatever the case may be. It's not there. And I don't know who the fuck I'm talking to on that other fucking phone on that line. I don't know if it's an attorney. It could be a fucking second. It could be just an average citizen. They could have switched my line over to the fucking opposition. It could be anybody that I'm talking to. I don't know who the fuck's on the end of that line. I'm not right there in their face. And I don't trust any of these lawyers here in the state that I'm in, period. I'm not going to I didn't try that already. But I've been trying to go to law firms and an attorney, and that's how big this shit is, because there's too many businesses involved. There's too much fucking money at play. You know what I'm saying? Like, even today when I went out the door, bro, motherfuckers recorded me left and right. I went to go get some fucking gum, some eggs, and some chicken. I really wanted to get some work. I really want. I shouldn't even fucking say that. I really want to go get some groceries. That shit. I don't know. This shit is crazy, bro. And that's where I'm at. That's where the fuck I'm at with it. And like I said, I got a bunch of phone calls just like that where I'm calling these law firms. And they're like, "Mom, just tell me. I'm not telling you shit. I'm asking you, what would you do in this particular situation?" And you switch to trying to get more information out of me. Fuck no, buddy. No. Motherfucker getting, bro. Like, think about it like this. This is the only way I can put it, hypothetically speaking. Or, you know. When you've been incarcerated, or you've been in the streets, you got junkies that run game like that. You know what I'm saying? This thing's greasy. You got junkies and other criminals that run game all day long. When you're in a controlled environment, these same people run the same fucking scenarios on you 24/7, or fucking stamps, honey buns, or whatever the hell the current currency of that particular institution is. You know what I'm saying? Whether it be fucking coffee, it doesn't matter, but that's what I'm getting at. And that's what I've been, and I got the proof. I got the proof like crazy. Got a bunch of it. And yeah, they didn't tell everybody in society, yeah, this motherfucker's a nut. He's crazy, whatever the case may be. Now if I fucking take some shit like that on the internet, that's another reason why I've been kind of like, if it's about even just putting that shit out there, because like, damn, I'm running the risk, because if I do jump out there and just put it online, then that might, I don't know. That's a whole nother category that I'm unfamiliar with. And then the thing is, if your internet, check this out, if your internet, your phone, your everything is compromised, I mean down to the everything, anytime you go to a store to get a new phone, your opposition will have your phone number, IME number, all that stuff, all your information on that phone before you even get it. Before it even gets in your hand, you turn the power on, they have all the information. And then when you contact these firms, they'll call right behind you, you know, and yeah, offer them a hellish amount of money, or say, "Hey, this motherfucker's a piece of shit," or whatever the hell they tell them to get them to fucking, it's just all fucked up. It's just all fucked up. So, I don't know. I gotta do some thinking. I'm actually pretty tired. I can't do any more woodworking because all my shit is, but I don't know, man. This is a lot. And that's just an example. This is just, that wasn't but like, what, 15 minutes? Called to whatchamacallit. This is fucked up, bro. This is a whole lot more to it. It's a whole lot more. As a matter of fact, I'm tired, I really need to lay down, but I gotta do shit, so I need to clean up and finish this drywall up today. And it's a lot. This is a lot. Like, even today. And they know that I got the information to put out there. They know it. It's like, I've been bullshitting, I'm not scared. You know what I'm scared of? I found out. I'm scared of crazy ass women, bro. I'm so fucking terrified of them because they could say anything, bro. If they ain't got no record, shoot you, and let it be a family member, you're fucking hit. Nigga, they gonna rock with that shit. Nigga, you gonna be looking like shit. You know what I'm saying? And depending upon who it is, you all the way hit, bro. You're all the way hit. You're all the way fucking hit. I don't know.
I went to district attorney's office. I call it GBI.
Okay. I need a fucking attorney. Because these folks are not going to help me.
You have reached the GBI Crime Lab. Please listen to the following selection so that we may route your call properly. If you're a representative from a law firm or an insurance company requiring a crime lab report, or if this is a public case inquiry, these requests must be submitted through open records at 404.
Hello, GBI, this is Kat.
Hey, I was trying to submit some information to the crime lab. I guess I got to make an open records request. Cause I tried to call directly. Yeah.
So, okay, what is it you're needing?
Some forensic science done. Some lab stuff.
Okay, are you with an agency?
No, I'm representing myself in the case.
Okay, so are you requesting records?
No, I'm requesting to get some labs done.
No, we don't do independent testing for anything.
Okay, when I just called the forensic science department, it said if you're a representative or if you're a law firm to make an open records request in order to get that.
Okay, you're making now open records request if we've already done something for you.
Okay, so how would I go about submitting that then?
What kind of case is it? Are you an attorney?
No, like I said, I'm representing myself.
Okay. Did we do any testing?
No, that's what I'm trying to get done.
Okay. We don't do independent testing.
But if I was an attorney, I can get it done then.
No, we don't take requests that way. If we work the case, it just depends on what kind of case, what county, because we don't do testing for every county in the state of Georgia. Now, if you're trying, what is it that you're trying to do?
I'm trying to get some lab work done or something.
Okay. We don't do lab work here unless we've been asked to do get involved in a case, is what I'm saying.
Okay. And as an individual, I can't submit a request to start an investigation.
No, you cannot.
Okay. What route would I take in order to do so?
What kind of investigation, sir?
A criminal investigation.
No. We don't take requests from citizens. It has to come from a law enforcement agency.
Okay, well, I was,
the governor. Uh-huh.
Well, I was instructed to go to the district attorney in my area, and I tried to do that, and they wouldn't let me speak to them at all.
Well, I don't know, but you asked a question as to can you get testing done here?
Mm-hmm.
No, you cannot get testing done. We don't do independent testing.
Only if it was concerning a pending case, pretty much.
If it's a case that GBI is involved in, and the only way we get involved in any cases is if we've been asked to do so by the agency, the governor, or a higher official within a government agency. Sheriff's office, a police department.
So what happens if I exhausted all those resources? I mean, because I went to a bunch of people and I just can't seem to get anywhere. Because it's kind of a big deal.
Okay, I'm not sure, sir, but what you may want to do, if it's an incident that has occurred here in Georgia, you would probably want to reach out to your sheriff's office or police department within the county where the incident occurred.
Well, those are the ones that need to be investigated, so then how does that work?
I'm sorry, say that again.
I said those are the ones that need to be investigated, so how does that work?
contact their attorney affairs office. Each agency have, if you want to report a situation or a police officer, you would contact that agency. And again, you would speak with someone in their attorney affairs office.
Yeah, I exhausted that resource already.
Okay. I don't know anything else to tell you. I do apologize. Like I said, I can't give you any advice as to what else you can do, but we don't do independent testing, nor will we open up an investigation based on a citizen's request.
Even if you have evidence, it doesn't matter, regardless, because I'm a citizen. I'm not, what if I was an attorney?
Okay, sir, you're asking questions, and I can't answer those questions.
Okay, I got you. I understand.
I don't know.
I understand. Okay, all right. Well, thank you so much for your time.
Okay, you have a good day.
See, that's what I get. I get nothing. But that's what I get. I get nothing. I get nowhere. I didn't already went to him, or whatever the case may be. How the fuck am I go to internal affairs from the police department? They're not gonna. They don't investigate themselves. They're fucking all buddy buddy. And they're my fucking fan, bro. I'm in on this shit. This shit is crazy. And I got the proof on them to fucking bring to. Might as well just bring it to the world, fuck it, and just take that shit how it comes. Everything's exhausted. Cause my family turned my friends on me. Turned the whole world on me. I can't go out the door without somebody recording me and shit like that. I can't get no work. I'm scared to do fucking any jobs or whatever, anybody's home, because they can say anything. Whatever the case may be. Funds is running low. Definitely can't afford attorney. Don't trust none of these attorneys in this fucking whole state at all. You know what I'm saying? Went down to the district attorney's office, tried to speak to them. They blocked me on that. You know what I'm saying? Because like she said, it has to be an official or somebody to start the investigation. I can't do it on myself, even if I got the proof. Even if motherfuckers literally trying to spin my top. Don't matter. Alright? But then if something goes wrong or whatever, if I defend myself in whatever way possible, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not saying being violent and just fucking shit trying to survive, I would be dead ass fucking wrong. And they're gonna paint a whole fucking different picture of, oh nah, this guy, he was just fucking blah 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 blah, you know what I'm saying? And all my family, none of them have a record, they've never been in trouble, and they're all female, so they could just say any fucking thing and people are gonna just rock with that shit, you know what I'm saying? And especially now with computer science and shit like that, and fucking Photoshop, you could damn videotape me out there in the street, minding my fucking business, and change it up and twist it to make it some other shit. You know what I'm saying? Shit's terrifying.
And they pretty much said, you know, matter of fact, this is a fact. If you call the GBI, because like, when you want to do an investigation on a police department, you call the GBI, right? You as a private citizen, you can't start an investigation. It has to come from another police officer or from the district attorney in that county. That's it. Unless it's human trafficking, drugs, and a couple other murders. It's like a couple other things, but it. The fact that they would not even let me speak to anybody to give me a chance. I'm like, listen, man, this is serious. Like, I need help. I'm dealing with dirty cops. They blew me off, bro. Straight like that. And I'm talking about, I went to so many different people like this up there. So, I'm tired. I'm exhausted. And think of it like this. Why would I go this route? You know what I'm saying? This is not something that you just put together like this. You know, so, I mean, I can't even get no employment, bro. Like, all my community, think of it like this. All the people got to do is go somewhere and just flash a badge.
Got our way in.
Illegally?
You got to put a word to it. It's like secret.
Illegal.
Look, we're going to...
And just say whatever and do whatever. Right? All my lines of communication compromised. I call, try to do anything. With to the modern technology today, it's just insane. I can't even go out the door without somebody taking a picture of me or putting a phone in my damn face. And it might just be in this area. It might not be out there where it can be. And they're saying, oh, he's crazy. He's this, he's that, this, that, and the third. And trying to stress me the fuck out until I snap. But, you know. Anyway, so look, y'all. I know it's a lot. And I've seemed like it's all over the place. But just stay with this story. Support this channel. Spread this, man. And go over to G-Spot Woodworking. Just help me. That's all I'm asking for, man. Just help me. And yeah, thank you. I'm out.
To dream the impossible dream. To fight the unbeatable foe. To bear with unbearable sorrow. To run where the brave dare not go. To right the unrightable wrong. To love pure and chaste from afar. To try when your arms are too weary. To reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far. To fight for the right, without question or pause. To be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world be better for this, that one man scorned and covered with scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage to fight the unbeatable foe.